have seen me before, haven't you? What did I just ask you? I asked you a mini question. But what is a mini question? A mini question is added to a statement in order to get a confirmation or an agreement from you. Have you guessed something? Could you guess the topic what we are going to talk about? Yes, my dear students, we are going to learn the question tags today. So, let's get started. Before understanding the question tag, let us see the characteristics of it. A question tag is a tail tag, meaning what? It is also known as a tail tag. We can also call a question tag as a tail tag. Secondly, it's a short question. It's a short or a mini question added at the end of the statement. It can be positive or negative in nature. A question tag can be positive or negative in nature. And lastly, it is an agreement or confirmation one expects from other person. So, understanding the four characteristics, let's take an example. If I say, Sachin is a good player, isn't he? Now, Sachin is a good player is my statement. I'm generally stating it that Sachin is a good player. But the moment I add, isn't he to it, that becomes my question tag. That is a tail that I am adding to the statement at the end of the statement, and I'm confirming from you that isn't he a good player, right? It is negative in nature. Since it is added at the end of the statement, it is called as a tail tag. Since it's a it comprises of two words, it's a two word question, that is why we call it as short or a mini question. It is negative in nature, and finally, it's an agreement or a confirmation I'm expecting from you people. So, I hope the characteristics are pretty clear to you with the help of the examples. Now, let's get further understanding the types of the question tag. My dear students, there are two types of question tags. They are positive and negative in nature. Now, listen very carefully. Positive question tag is attached to the negative statement. I haven't written it wrong, my dear children. Yes, a positive question tag is always added to the negative statement. Let's take an example. You are not upset. This is a negative statement. And this, are you? This two little word is my positive question tag. Since not has been added here, this becomes my negative statement. And here I have added a positive question tag to it. Okay, so clear with this point? A positive question tag will always be added to the negative statement. Some of the examples are they, did she, will you, is he? These are some of the examples of positive question tag. Now let's understand the second type of question tag. It is negative question tag. Now negative question tag is always attached to the positive statement. Let's take an example. You are upset. This is my general statement. You are upset is a general positive statement, and aren't you? See children, aren't you? This is negative in nature. So my dear students, you have to very well keep this thing in mind. The science formula that opposite things attract each other. When a positive question tag is there, we will attach it to the negative statement. And when a negative statement is there, we will attach a positive question tag, and vice versa. So let's take examples of this. Aren't they? Didn't she? Won't you? Isn't he? These are some of the examples of negative question tag. So clear with this? There is just a simple formula to it, that a positive question tag will be attached to a negative statement, and a negative question tag will be attached to the positive statement. Now children, let us proceed towards the rules of formation of question tags. The first one. What if we have auxiliary verb present in the statement? If we have the auxiliary verb present in the statement, we will directly use that auxiliary verb in the question tag. Let's see with an example. The fruits are fresh. Here, the subject is the fruits, and are is my auxiliary verb. So here, since the statement is positive, I will be using the negative question tag to it. That is, aren't. And since the fruits are more than one, so I'll be taking they to it. So clear with this? The statement is positive, I'll be taking the negative nature of that. Secondly, what if there are no verbs, no auxiliary verbs in the sentence? In that case, we have to see the main verb in the sentence. And in that main verb, we have to see the tense of the verb. Okay. Now first, let's understand the mini rule of the main verbs and then we'll see the examples. If we have V1 in the statement, that is a simple verb, we will be using do to it. If we have V2, we will be using did. And if we have V6, now what is V6? V6 is a combination of V1 plus S or ES. In that case, we will be using the does question tag. Now let's understand it with the help of examples. The first example is birds build nest on trees. Now here, my build is my main verb and it is in simple present tense. So which question tag I'll be using? Do. I'll be using do to it. But since the statement is positive in nature, I'll be taking the don't form. Do not. So don't. Birds are more than one, so don't they. The next sentence is, he finished the given work, didn't he? Now, he finished the given work. In this, finished is my V2. It's the verb form, is the verb for a past tense of finish. Okay, so we will be using did to it. Okay, so he finished the given work, didn't he? Since my subject, he is already present in the statement, I'll be using the same subject. Okay, the subject and auxiliary verb must be same. This we have to clearly keep in mind. The last example is, my sister likes tea, doesn't she? Here, likes is my V6. Why? Because it is the combination of V1 plus S or ES. Here, this is my V6, so I'll be using doesn't to it. Since my sister is female in nature, I have used she to it. Okay, so my sister likes tea, doesn't she? So this is a short mini rule that you have to keep in mind. Now what if in the situation, if in the statement, if we see two verbs present in the statement, in that case, what we have to do? If there are double verbs in the sentence, what to do in that case? Let's understand it. I think it's very important to stay fit. Okay, here to stay is my verb and think is also my verb, but to stay is my infinitive. Okay, so we won't touch that. Then we see that this is strong in nature. This is a strong verb, so we will consider it. So let's understand. It is the auxiliary verb given here, so we will be using the negative of that statement. Okay, since the statement is positive, we have to use the negative of it. So isn't it becomes my question tag. So understood, we have to see whether in the statement, whether the verb has been accompanied with to or is it an ing form. So we won't be touching that. Now let's understand some exceptions. My dear students, as you know that English is a funny language and in grammar we have lots and lots of exceptions. Let us understand that. If the question tag for am is aren't or aren't I, here for am, we can't use am't I, right? There is nothing as am't I. We don't say am't I. So, aren't I or this, the pronunciation of aren't I and aren't I here is same, but the spelling is different. For example, I am late. Since this is positive in nature, I will be using the negative form of it. Aren't I or aren't I? The pronunciation is same, the meaning is same, just a spelling difference is there. Let's move towards the next rule. What if the sentence begin with let or let us? If the sentence begin with let us or let's, then we will be using shall we or shan't we to it. Let's understand it with an example. Let us work together, shall we or shan't we? Let us work together, shan't we? Let us work together, shall we? Both are correct. Similarly, if there are indefinite pronouns, if the sentence begin with an indefinite pronoun, now what all things come in indefinite pronoun? Someone, anybody, somebody, nobody. In that case, we have to always use the plural form. Okay, it's plural verb we have to take. Okay, for example, everyone is present. Now the sentence has started with everyone. Is there positive in nature? So, but since every here you might be confused that I haven't used isn't here. But children, this is an indefinite pronoun and this is an exception that I am talking about. Okay, when the sentence begin with an indefinite pronoun, we always use the plural form of it. And if you people might have known this, that in be form, for singular tense we use is and for plural we use are. So here I am considering the plural form, everyone is my plural form, and that is why I have used aren't they to it. Remember this very carefully. Okay, now if the sentence begin with an imperative, if the sentence is an imperative statement, meaning it can be a command, it can be a request, it can be an advice and so on. If the sentence begin with an if a sentence is an imperative statement, we have to see the positive and the negative nature of that statement, and then we have to use won't we or will you accordingly. For example, for positive we will be using won't you, and for the negative we will be using will you. Lock the door, this is positive in nature, so we will be using the negative question tag. Okay, won't you. Okay, and don't lock the door, this is negative in statement, so we will be using a positive question tag to it, that is will you. Okay, I hope this much is clear to you. Now let's quickly recap what we have studied in the session. Firstly, we saw what are the characteristics of question tag. It is also known as a tail tag. It can be positive or negative in nature. It's an agreement or a confirmation one expects from someone. And lastly, it's a short or a mini question. Now these were the four characteristics that we studied. Then we saw the two types of question tag, positive and negative. Here I told you to keep the science formula in mind that opposite things attract each other. If the positive statement is there, we will be using a negative statement to it and vice versa. Then we saw few rules. In first rule we saw, if the auxiliary verb is present in the statement, we will directly use that auxiliary verb in the question tag. If there is no auxiliary verb, then we have to see the main verb, and in that main verb we have to see the tense of the verb and then decide whether do, did or does will come. Okay, then we saw the double verb type. In that double verb type we have to see whether which is the strong verb, whether the verb has been accompanied with to, is it an infinitive, then we don't have to touch that, we have to see the strong verb and then decide the question tag. Then we saw the exceptions of question tag, that for am the question tag is always used as aren't I or aren't I. The spellings are different but the pronunciation and meaning are same. Then we saw that if the sentence begin with let us, we will use shall we or shan't we. Then we saw the imperative sentence. In the imperative sentence, if the sentence is positive or negative, we have to use won't you or will you depending upon the positive or negative nature of it. So dear children, I hope the session was pretty clear to you. The topic has been, I was able to suffice your need. It was clear to you. Thank you so much.